Hey there, my name is Matt. I'm here at Precuber, a precision mold making company based in Germany. Do you ever have modeled individual parts during your prototyping process, or had you manually changed tools like this one and ask yourself how to create a CAD model out of this without having any data for your next production steps? Today we're going to show you how to create a CAD file out of your physical model by using the ATOS Q to scan the part and our software ZEISS Reverse Engineering to generate your CAD file out of your scan data. Let's get started from scan to CAD. The first step is scanning the part and creating a mesh. I'm using ATOS Q here since it is the perfect fit to this task as it can capture the detail in a very easy way and has the required accuracy. After scanning of the part with an ATOS Q, we check if we have everything and clean up the mesh where needed. Then we can align the mesh in a certain coordinate system in ZEISS Inspect, which helps to easily orient the mesh afterwards, and we have defined the origin of the mesh. Let us export the STL file to ZEISS Reverse Engineering with the use of Direct Interface, which automatically starts ZEISS Reverse Engineering, opens a new project of ZEISS Reverse Engineering, and import aligned STL data of the part. Now we have the mesh ready for the next steps in our reverse engineering software, and we can start our virtual modeling. We can reverse engineer whatever the shape of your part is. This tool consists only of standard geometries, so in this case, we will reverse engineer in a constructive way. We start with creating the base body. After that, we create step by step the different standard geometries. Like this big cylinder in the middle. The software supports us by using the dynamic subselection. This function selects necessary areas for different elements automatically, and we do not need to select it manually. If there are interruptions between, you can use Ctrl key to multi-select the necessary areas. We will do this depending on direction and position. Afterwards, we intersect or unite these elements with the base body using the Boolean operation. A tip at this point, in general, we always start from the outside inwards to end up with a perfect CAD model. If there are parts that you have not been able to scan, such as for example drill holes, you can easily create them by using 2D elements. This way, we are able to create a solid body for these areas as well. As we are using the ATOS Q, we were able to scan all areas because of its triple scan principle. To finalize the model, we create the fillets and chamfers edges. At the end, you can export a step, IHS and set file. For more how-tos, getting started tutorials, product updates or any other questions and topics on 3D scanning, please go to handsonmetrology.com. You will find the link in the information section of the video. Thanks for watching.